JCR Garage. So this time we are doing something I've done for the past 15 years, this second weekend of August, but I've never shown it on camera. It is what I talked about a couple of videos ago when I was doing all the motorcycles that we have. It is the meetup. It is the oldest meetup for tempo mopeds and motorcycles in the world, which is pretty much just the first one they ever did, and it's still in the same place 20, 30 years later. And I am in the Granada with a trailer in tow with my brother's moped on it. And ahead of me is my dad in the 6 Falcon with my moped and his on the trailer behind him. So we just took off from home. Now we are going to the store to buy a little bit of, well, food and drinks and all that to last the weekend. Behind me I have a big tent, sleeping bags, and one of those gas kitchens, chairs, table, and all that in the back seat, as well as a few drinks in a bag right next to me, as well as a little change of clothes and some rain attire, because it's been raining really badly today, and it's apparently not going to stop until, well, tomorrow. But that is what we're used to, because it's been like that the past couple of years we've been there. So, and with me not having a mirror in the window, I can't see the moped behind me without turning. So, I brought a couple of power banks to keep everything kind of charged, because there is no electricity there. There's a field in the middle of the forest. There is no electricity other than that you bring with cars. So of course I have the car with the charger in it for my phone, which I used to film. I brought my old phone, which is the one I've used for YouTube ever since I started, and the action cam that I've used sometimes for B-roll footage with its handlebar mount, so I can mount it on the handlebars of my moped while we're on the drive tomorrow. So I'm gonna be taping some of that, and I don't know when I'm gonna be putting this video out, because I know if one of the guys that usually are there comes, he usually runs ahead of everyone else on the on his motorcycle and stops every here and there to film people passing by. I'll see if I maybe can borrow some of his footage and edit that in along with the driving. For the program, what's gonna happen is tonight there is just, you know, setting up the camp and all that, talking to everyone you haven't seen in a year. Then it is, my brother is coming up. He's at work until 5, so he's working for, well, he's at work for another half hour. He gets off at 4:30, and he is 3 hours away, so he is gonna be packing up his car right after work and leaving around 5, probably be here 7 or 8, depending on how quickly it goes. So I'm guessing he's gonna be here around 8. That's why I have his moped in tow, because he's bringing that back home with him afterwards, along with the trailer, because that's my mom's trailer, and they live at the same place. So he can bring her trailer and his moped back down, instead of me going down there with it. And for tomorrow's program, usually people have a couple of drinks tonight, so there will be a little bit of a delay in the parting tomorrow. But usually we go around 2, and that's what you're used to, so we won't be leaving. Well, we'll probably get up around 11 or 12, and then use a couple of hours to like recuperate from the night before heading out to go pretty much on just that little drive. It's just a drive on the regular road up to the, well, place that I usually go to when I'm filming. There to the store where we park up in a big lineup all together. And there is a car following us with room to spare for, you know, shopping that most people would buy. And then store that in there to go back to the place. And then we run across the mountain over a dirt road with a lot of, well, usually around here at least, we've set the animals. By animals, I mean like cattle and sheep, goats. Goats, but cows and sheep are usually set free up on the mountains during the summer. And well, where we're passing through tomorrow on the mopeds, there is gonna be quite a bit of cows. I might have to honk my horn at my dad soon because his handles are starting to turn and I'm thinking it might topple over up there. I'm gonna have to be on the watch out for that, as well as turning around to see the one behind me. And yeah, I will see if I can maybe shoot a couple of snapshots when I get up there of how everything's looking. The meat site, I was there last week, actually a week ago, just to look at how the might have fucked up. A shifter popped out. I can't get it back into gear. Oh, I should have fixed this. I was in fourth. Now the shifter's stuck, damn it. All right, back on track. I had to stop, pull over, and pretty much yank the rubber booth out that's underneath the center console and get the shifter back in its hole, as well as taking the shift knob off. But now I am back in gear. So I'll have to fix this when I get, well, to the meetup. Get it shoved back in, and it's gonna be a little bit more noise because now there is pretty much a hole through the floor straight onto the transmission. So, like I said, I'll see you over there.
Björn må ha to. Det var ikke noe drifte.